First of all, I am thankful to the organizers for selecting me to speak on this topic, because 25 years of my career I had been handling information technology, and 2 years back I have moved to health related industry, Hindustan Antibiotics, as managing director. So M Health is the topic which I prefer. And I am very much impressed about the initiatives taken by Maharashtra government in the M Health sector, as we have seen from the previous presentation. As a person who has been passionate to promote information technology in the country, I am very happy about it. In the early 80s, I have ventured into write computer science in Malayalam. It was taken well by the public, and finally it ended up in publishing 8 books in information related topics. And I am happily watching how India is forging ahead among the nations in the IT sector. Coming back to M Health, all of you know M Health stands for mobile health, and M Health is a subset of e health, electronic health. Functionally, both are same, but technically there is a difference. In e health, the infrastructure used is the traditional IT networking, that is wired networks, whereas in M Health it is mobile devices, wireless networks. Watching the developments happening in the healthcare sector and the information technology sector, I observe vast scope for the country and for the people in M Health. I also observe that the country is well equipped to harness the benefits of M Health. One of the previous presentations, we have seen how the country is gearing up with creating more bandwidth in the networking, because M Health requires high bandwidth, because pictures, x-rays, all have to be transmitted over the network. Through M Health, there are various services which we can deliver to the people. One is in the administrative side, that we have already seen. The health information system, that MIS system for the health department, the information about the administration of health department, from right from primary health centers to the administrative head of the health department. Then comes the patient information system. Morning, we have been hearing a lot about the UID. So if the Aadhaar number is connected to the health information of every citizen, just by giving the Aadhaar number to the doctor, within few seconds, the doctor gets all the data, all the medical history of the patient in his computer, so that a lot of time and effort can be saved. Lot of diagnostic testing can be avoided, because till yesterday what is the condition of the body is available on the screen of the doctor. So treatment can be started quick. Otherwise, what is happening, even if the patient is going to die, much of the valuable time will be wasted on testing and testing. By the time all the testings are over, patient may die. So this, then these underdeveloped countries, this M health is very important, because there are a lot of rural areas where these latest medical facilities are not available, and good these super specialist doctors are also not available. But through telemedicine, even medical data can be transmitted to the super specialists sitting in big cities or in major hospitals. The ECG reports or the test results can be sent, and instantaneous diagnosis can be done and a treatment can be started. Another area is the medical documentation. We all know about this medical transcription happening and for insurance purpose and all. More than this, what is more contributing is the advent of more sophisticated monitoring devices of the human body now being made available in the market. Today is 2nd August 2014. Let us go to 2nd August 2019 to a consulting room of a cardiologist. A lady comes to the doctor for a heart checkup. That time he may offer her a new brassiere. I am referring to the Techno Bra, a new kind of brassiere developed by a company in Paris, which can be worn by ladies, which is embedded with electronic circuits, which monitors the heartbeat. If the heartbeat is normal, no problem. But if any abnormality is noticed, the message will go to the husband or father and simultaneously to her doctor. And the instruction for, if it is serious, instruction for the remedial measures will be generated and action will be taken immediately. Now that nanotechnology is contributing much to the medical technology, instead of inserting the pacemaker and all, now a nanomaterial membrane has been developed in one Illinois hospital, which can be covered in your chest. It can be fixed on your chest so that whenever the electronic pulses which controls the heartbeats are not proper, it gives corrective shocks so that heart will work normally even if any problem is there. And if this is repeated many times, the database will collect it and proper information will be sent to the concerned doctor. Similarly, there are the wrist bits, that is the monitoring devices which you can wear like a wrist watch. It will monitor your pulses. Any abnormality is there, it will give you proper signal. Just like that, any body symptoms can be sensed and transmitted through wireless networks to anybody, anywhere. So this avoids the frequent visits to the doctor for checkups. It avoids a lot of very costly diagnostic procedures. If a signal is there that something is abnormal, then only you go for detailed testing. So it saves a lot of money. This is very important for countries which is finding it difficult to mobilize the resources for medical care. And for the sensing devices worn in the human body, most of them are working on batteries. To provide electricity for the same, body itself can create battery through nanotechnology. You know this, by the movement of your dress, such movements can be, that creates some energy. Very little energy, but that is sufficient for the functioning of the mobile devices worn by the humans. You might have read about the piezoelectric shoes. Anyway, while walking, there are a lot of energy is created because of our weight and the friction on our shoes. If a piezoelectric material is kept in the shoes while walking, electricity can be generated, and this can be used for the mobile devices kept on your body. How is it possible? That is called a PAN, after LAN and WAN. Now this is PAN, that is personal area network. Through the dress you wear, nowadays the dress can be embedded with narrow electricity transmitting conducting wires, so that a network can be created within your body, which can be connected to the mobile devices, to your ornaments, to your watches and earrings, all those things. And these things will work after, by talking each other, and if any abnormality is noticed, signals, messages will go to the concerned persons. And to complement this GPS navigation facilities to locate you where you are, if you are out of station, where you are located, so that treatment can be arranged at the earliest. That is also now available. The advantage is that a country like India, where a lot of rural areas are there, where the traffic, wired networks have not reached, even electricity is not there, but mobile phones are there. In this kind of situation, the most sophisticated treatment facilities are made available to the common man very fast and very effectively at very less cost. This is very important from the economic point of view. In addition to that, this mHealth provides a lot of business opportunities and job opportunities for the upcoming young generation of our country. Considering the demographics, the so-called demographic dividend of our country, which we are possessing now, this kind of job opportunities and business opportunities are very important. This is more relevant for India because India is now a leader in information technology. So when the devices which I was talking about, it will be millions and millions of devices because our population is now more than 120 crores. Even 1% of the population uses such devices. It itself is a big business. Not only selling the manufacturing and selling the devices, these devices require servicing. It requires applications, software applications. And software applications have to be supported. Once we are mastering this kind of expertise, it is not only India, because only Indians can master, develop and master this kind of expertise at cheaper levels. Then definitely, just like our software services, other countries will have to hire our services and our companies to avail these services. It is going to open a very good opportunity for business and employment for our people. I am very happy to find that companies like Dell, HCL, GE Healthcare are all have all realized this potential, and they are already in the line, and a lot of activities have taken place. They are already realized the advantage. Not only that, next to information technology, pharma is an area where India is contributing much to the world through exports. 85,000 crores of rupees has been earned last year by pharma exports. But very few medicines are developed in India. because research and development for pharma is very costly. If you try 1,000 medicines, one or two will be finally commercially marketed because it takes a lot of time and money. It is estimated that 40,000 crores of rupees will be required to successfully develop and market a new molecule. But thanks to the modern technology and the developments in nanotechnology and chemoinformatics, this time and cost of research and development can be brought down like anything. Now that anyway, research and development, this clinical trials is a very costly affair. Now, because by 3D printing, three-dimensional printing, we can create artificial organs. These artificial organs are capable of conducting the first or second level of clinical trials. Last trial can be on actual human bodies. So this kind of technologies can cut down the cost of research and development, and that is going to be helpful for India. Anyway, there are a lot of things. So other speakers are also there. I am cutting it down. But one thing I want to, one thing is that this application, mobile applications for mHealth is developed mostly by IT experts. Doctors are not involved. Day by day, doctors are sent out of hospitals and engineers are conquering. The danger is that many applications are not properly regulated, that is, it is not tested properly. The Food and Drug Administration of the authorities are very much aware of it. A lot of actions are being taken. Anyway, mHealth is here to stay. We are gearing up, our country is gearing up for the same. Let us hope the best will come out. Thank you all.